when you train in this, then when you are well trained in this exchange practice, then even without the efforts that the paramita practices, the perfection practices, one could do naturally, one could naturally enter. And so therefore, the purpose of this teaching is to be able to do that. So therefore, this studying and contemplating on this teaching is being able to carry the bodhisattva activities, bodhisattva practice, and naturally.
只有当我们很好的修持这个能够很好的修持这个自他交换的修法的时候呢，我们根本不需着力，完全不需着力，我们也能够很自然的契入这个波罗这个六波罗蜜的修持。所以这个目的呢，就是为了达到这一点。所以我们必须闻思修这个自他观修法呢，最终圆满的才能够完成这个菩萨的佛行事业，还有这个修持，很自然的去完成它。
So this short teaching, the skillful method is to explain how to be able to carry on the exchange practice.
所以这里的这个简短的教法呢，是主要是要说明一个很善巧的这个法门来解释。 我们怎么能够修持这个自他交换的观修法？
And the root of this lies that one should cherish all sentient beings without any prejudice, without any exception, that all sentient beings to hold a very precious.
所以这个修法的根本呢，最重要的那个重点呢，就是我们必须完全的去珍惜每一个有情众生，完全的不去歧视他们，没有任何的意外。
And so therefore, which this one has the 8 verses, so the first 7 verses, along with the reasons and examples, that explains how important to cherish the others and to see others as a very precious.
所以在这里呢，总共有8个偈颂。首7个偈颂呢，主要是要他讲明说这些原因，还有提供例子来解释珍惜他人，把他人看成是无上的如意宝，是多么的重要。
And then the last one, 8th verse, the mind also have to be free from the thoughts.
所以这最后一个偈颂，也就是第八个偈颂呢，重点就是说心呢要如何完全的不受心念的这个左右。
In other words, as it has 8 verses, first 7 verses are training in the relative bodhicitta or relative enlightenment mind precept, and the 8th one is training in the absolute enlightenment precept.
所以呢，首七个偈颂呢，主要是要训练我们的这个相对的这个菩提心。 然后第八个偈颂呢，要讲的呢，主要是这个绝对的菩提心。So
the first one is to give the reasons, the why that we have to cherish the others, and then after realizing that, then to explain the actual exchange practice.
所以首先呢，第一个寄送呢，要讲的是为什么我们要珍惜他人，然后之后呢，再解释说怎么样的去实际的修持这样的一个修法。
And so the first is by explaining the reason why that it is important to do this, and also then to give it with the examples.
那第一个寄送呢？要解释说，解释那个原因，就是为什么这么重要，然后同时呢，提供例子。
So the first verse which says that with the wish to achieve the highest aim, which surpasses even the wish fulfilling gym, I shall train myself to at all times cherish sentient beings.As supreme.
第一个寄送呢讲的就是说我于一切有情众视之尤胜如意宝愿成半比究竟力恒时爱惜诸有情
So this explains now to accomplish the Buddhahood depends on the sentient beings. If there is no sentient beings then one could not practice love.Patience, generosity, etc.
所以这第一个寄送要讲的就是说，要圆证佛果呢，必须依赖有情众生。没有有情众生的话，我们是没有办法证得佛果的。
And so therefore, since the entire Buddhahood, accomplishing the Buddhahood, depends on the other sentient beings.So therefore, it is very important to cherish the other sentient beings.
所以呢，既然要圆证佛果，我们必须依赖一切这些众生，所以就很重要的，我们必须很珍惜、很爱惜诸有情众生。